Hello, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are all doing great. Today I have a Van Cleef & Arpels Alhambra review video, wear and tear, and I'm also going to give you guys tips. This video was highly requested. I get tons of DMs, emails asking me about my Van Cleef pieces, how they've been holding up, my recommendations, any tips, all that. So I'm going to share as much as possible with you guys. I really hope you guys find this video helpful. One thing I want to add though is that I will try to insert some close-up photos when necessary, but I'm not going to get into too much detail about all the little details about each piece, just because I want to help you guys as much as possible with the review video. However, I know that there's a lot of people out there that are watching these kind of videos to replicate the item, and to, you know, it just doesn't sit well with me. So I am going to insert a few clips of close-ups here and there, but I'm not going to be inserting like my serial number or what it looks like, or labels, important logo related close-ups. So I hope you guys understand that, and without further ado, let's get started. I only have four items from Van Cleef & Arpels. All four items are from the Alhambra collection. I absolutely love the Alhambra collection. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, the Alhambra collection is the one that looks kind of like a clover. And I'm only going to be talking about, obviously, the Alhambra line. That's what I have. Right now, the pieces that I have are obviously these two bracelets. I have a pair of earrings, and I also have this necklace right here, and I absolutely love this piece. So I'm gonna get started with first each different stone and my tips on when buying, what to look into. My first tip would be to buy in store if possible. If you guys don't have a store near you, I would recommend you would have to just buy it online, just because when you buy it online, you don't have to pay for shipping, but when you order it from store, then you would have to pay for shipping. I believe shipping is like $30 or something like that, if I'm not mistaken. But if you are very picky about serial numbers and the way you want your stone and things like that, then the $30 or paying for shipping might be worth it. The first piece that I added into my collection, this is in the color red, and it is called the carnelian. Mine is in the rose gold hardware. All carnelians come with only the rose gold hardware when it comes down to this kind of bracelet. These two are the sweet Alhambra bracelets. You also have the vintage Alhambra, which is a bigger size. So as a comparison, you can see that the vintage Alhambra is a lot bigger. You could also get the vintage in a bracelet version. I personally liked the sweet Alhambra just because I like daintier jewelry. So for this one, I decided to go as my first one. The reason why I say that if you are picky, you might want to get it in store, or maybe call someone and have an SA send you photos, is because when it comes down to the carnelian bracelet, it's all in different shades of red. So if you are picky about the shades of red that you want, then like I said, you might want to call in the store. I'm not sure if you can actually put a note on your online purchase, and I'm not sure how closely they will follow your notes, but I wanted personally something that's more closer to like a darker red, something deep. And I've also seen some carnelian bracelets that were more of like a pop of red, a lighter red. So if you are picky with the shades of reds, then it might just be worth paying for shipping and then being able to pick the shades of red that you want. So the next piece that I added into my collection is actually this one. This is actually the same exact type of bracelet. It's a sweet Alhambra, and I got mine in the mother of pearl, and this only comes in the yellow gold hardware. Now in earrings and necklaces and things like that, the mother of pearl, you can also get them in white gold. In the sweet Alhambra version, you could only get the mother of pearl with the yellow gold. You could actually see the difference. I feel like VCA or Van Cleef & Arpels does a really beautiful rose gold or pink gold. I think there's a really clear difference between the rose gold and the yellow gold. I heard that Cartier's pink gold doesn't hold up well, meaning over time it tends to turn a little more in like the yellow side, so sometimes it's really hard to tell between the two. I had no problems with my carnelian, the rose gold turning or looking more yellowish over time. The tip that I have with the mother of pearl, any size, whether it's the sweet, the vintage, or whatever, if you are particular about the type of mother of pearl or the look of mother of pearl that you want, it might be well worth it to call the store and see if your SA can send you photos. I noticed that not all of them are the same, in the sense of the one that I picked, I wanted something that was flat, nothing bumpy. As you guys know, pearls, some of them natural pearls, not all of them are solid and flat. So some of them did have a little more bumps than others. Also, some of them are a little more in the ivory pearl color, while I saw that others had a little bit more of a yellow tint. Some of them had more of a little slightly blue tint. So if you are, I think, more than the carnelian, if you are particular, most definitely the mother of pearl, I would, if possible, see it in store or maybe see photos or anything like that. The next piece that I added into my collection would have to be my Sweet Alhambra earrings, and these are in the onyx stone, which is the black. These also come in the yellow gold, and I'm not sure if it comes with the white gold. I think I've seen it in the white gold, but I believe that those were in the vintage size, which is, like I said, this size. So this is the vintage size, like I mentioned earlier, but I absolutely love the black and the yellow. This stone I really like because it is super carefree. When I spoke with my SA before purchasing any of my Van Cleef & Arpels items, I mentioned to her that I really don't have time to be taking on and off my earrings, my bracelets, and things like that. I will be honest that my earrings, I will take it on and off when I feel like switching earrings, but when I'm not switching earrings, I just keep them. So I keep them on, I sleep with them, I shower with them, anything and everything, I just keep them on. With the bracelets, honestly, it is such a pain to take these on and off, especially because I'm right-handed and I wear these on my right. So having to kind of clip them on and off, it is such a pain. So I never take these off. I don't take them off for anything unless I have to, in the sense of having to be mandatory. So I know I get a lot of DMs asking if I'm sure that I don't take them off and they want to confirm, but yeah, I don't take them off. And that's what I mentioned to my SA. What my SA said, and this is me asking multiple times every time I did a new purchase, just because I wanted to make sure that I get the same answer. The answer, it's always, it's recommended that you take it off, but if you don't take it off, it's no big deal. But that's only with the certain stones that you own. So for instance, out of all the stones that I showed you guys right now, which are the three stones, the safest one to be able to keep your stone on and that it won't damage, change, or anything like that would be the onyx. The onyx is the most hard-wearing one. The second one is the carnelian, and the third one I was told that is the mother of pearl. Now, if you are thinking of getting the green one, which I believe it's called, I don't remember what it's called, but I'll put it right here. But the green one is actually deadly to water. So if you buy that one, if you are thinking of that buying that one, keep in mind that you should not shower with it, you should not get it wet, and you should be taking it on and off on the daily. Now, there's also a brown one, which I don't know, and I can't remember off the top of my head what it's called, to be honest, and I'll also leave it here. And I'm not too familiar with that one, but I know that it's not as hard wearing as these, but it's not as sensitive as the green one. So just an FYI, if you are looking into other stones and if you are a person that keep jewelry on, I would recommend the ones that I have, because that's what I was told. I was told that it is the most hard wearing. And the last one that I added into my collection would be this one right here. This is my vintage Alhambra necklace, also in the onyx and in the yellow gold hardware. Like I said, I believe this also comes in the white gold hardware, if I'm not mistaken. The reason why I ended up getting or going for the vintage one is because I wanted to match it with my earrings. I wanted a set for nicer occasions. If I have weddings and I want to wear a set, I feel like this would be so beautiful. These two items, so the necklace and the earrings, or any onyx stoned items in general, I think you would be pretty safe with ordering them online because they all look identical. They're all the same. They all have they're all black, they're all, you know, there's no changes where you can pick and choose. The only thing that you can pick and choose when it comes down to the onyx stones would be the serial number. If the serial number is something that matters to you, then you might want to call in and again order it through the phone or go into the store. So that pretty much covers all the four pieces that I have in my collection. Now I would like to get into wear and tear. Like I mentioned earlier, I don't take these off unless I have to. My earrings, when I feel like switching out of them, I switch out of them, so I don't really keep them on 24/7. And same with my necklace. When I have it on, I have it on. If I feel like switching out, I'll switch it out. So it's not like I'm very careful with them. I should be with the price point, but it's nice to know that they've been holding up great and I've had no issues with these at all. I don't have any shrinkage. It looks great. Nothing is loosening up. My crowns are great. I will have to say that I don't remember if it was the red one or my mother of pearl, but the crown was a little loose to begin with when I first bought one, and it kept snagging things, you know, while I'm making my bed or putting clothes on or whatever. It would snag or get caught in my clothing, and so I did take it in and they were able to fix it. It took a few weeks, I believe. I would have to say maybe like 3 weeks or so. I believe I mentioned it in one of my videos about me taking it in, and they fixed it. It came back and I've had no problems ever since. But I did not have any shrinkage, change of color, nothing at all. They have been holding up great. I love the Sweet Alhambra personally. I get a lot of compliments every time. I'm not sure if they compliment me because they think it's cute or if they compliment it because they know it's Van Cleef & Arpels. I love how subtle it is. A lot of people don't know of this brand, and I think sometimes it's nice to have something that it's luxury but yet it's subtle. Like this screams, you know, Cartier love bracelet and price tag, but these on the other hand, not really. And I really like that about the set, the necklace. That's what I really love about Van Cleef & Arpels. If you know, you know. If you don't, you don't. I honestly highly recommend it. I absolutely love them. It's so carefree. Obviously, if you are able to take better care of your jewelry, then that would be nice. But the fact that you don't have to, it gives you that security that I'm not going to ruin them. And also, if you have a boutique near you, it's nice that you can always take your Van Cleef & Arpels pieces in and they will clean them for you. So every so often, every 6 months or so, I do stop by and I give them all my pieces at once, and they have no problem with taking it to the back and getting all of them cleaned. I think that's a good way to kind of maintain your jewelry clean and make sure that there's nothing wrong with them. I have nothing but great things to say about Van Cleef & Arpels. Their customer service, again, has been great. For those of you guys that don't know, Cartier and Van Cleef are connected from the same company, so that's kind of nice to know too. So there's two cons that I'm not a big fan when it comes on to Van Cleef & Arpels or the pieces that I have. Well, actually it's three, but then one of them got fixed. So the first one was the one that was when the little crown was a little loose and it was kind of pooling on everything. If you have a piece and you feel like it's doing that, it's because the crown is loose, and if you take it in, they will fix that for you free of charge. So that's nice. That's not a problem that I've had ever since that's been fixed. The other thing that is a con is that I'm right-handed and I cook a lot. I cook on the daily, and when I cook, obviously stirring the pot over the stove, these, I don't know if it's because it's thin, like the chain itself is thin, it heats up really quickly. So there's a lot of times when I'm cooking, stirring the pot or whatever it is, and I can feel the heat kind of coming into my wrist and it burns. So I have to quickly remove my whole arm and let it kind of cool down. So again, I don't have that problem with the Cartier bracelet, but number one, I don't stir with my left hand. And number two, I don't know if it's because this is a much thicker material, so it does take a little longer to heat. So that's something that I wanted to mention about these bracelets. I still love them regardless, but it is worth mentioning if you are someone that cooks a lot and you are thinking of using them in the dominant hand, that might be one thing. The next thing also might not be a big deal, but like I said, I shower with these, and I also put lotion on my body from head to toe every time I shower. So as you can imagine, you can also get lotion on these. I try to be careful when it comes down to lotion, but honestly speaking, I've gotten lotion on this plenty of times. I'm going to show a close up, but if you guys can see right in between the stone, there's like a little indent. And in the little indent, a lot of like, I guess, stuff get on it, whether it's lotion, whether it's just dirt, whether it's, so you have to kind of clean that once in a while. What I do is I just grab like a thin, soft toothbrush and I kind of go around it and I kind of remove any dust or any residue or anything that might be stuck in there. But all the Van Cleef & Arpels pieces have that. So the necklace also has that little indent in between, and also the earrings. So if you are very picky about, you know, dust and residue and things like that, that is something that you might have to do, especially if you are planning to wear your pieces all the time. Another con that I almost forgot to mention is that if you are really picky about fingerprints or things like that kind of bother you, the onyx and the carnelian, because they are kind of shiny, they do pick up fingerprints. So personally for me, I don't really mind it. I just get like a piece of cloth and then I'll clean it out. So fingerprints don't really bother me, but I've actually had some people kind of mentioning that to me and if it's a big deal or not. So I guess it kind of depends on your personality. If fingerprints bother you, then the onyx and the carnelian might not be for you. So I do want to tell you guys a little bit about, be careful with the things that you see online, especially if you are thinking of buying things pre-loved. I actually came across, I don't know if it's because Van Cleef & Arpels is becoming somewhat popular, but I've came across a lot of fakes, in the sense that, that's probably why I don't really want to show a lot of close-ups in this video, but I've seen a lot of fakes that are obviously fakes. Like, you can see it in the crown, you can see it in the shape, and sometimes they add colors that are not even existent. So please look online to see if the item that you're looking at even exists. So for instance, an example would be these Sweet Alhambras. There's only 4 different ways that it comes in. So you have the carnelian, you have the sweet, the mother of pearl, it also comes in the rose gold, and it also comes in white gold with diamonds. Those are the only 4. And I've seen them selling online in the Sweet Alhambra size, in the onyx stone. And that doesn't even exist. It doesn't exist. So please do your research, look online. I started coming across a lot of fake ones, which is kind of scary. So I did want to really give you guys that tip. So I think that's all I have for you guys in this video. I'm hoping that I covered everything and I'm not forgetting anything. I would highly recommend that if you are really interested in purchasing one of these pieces, that you look through my jewelry playlist. I know that through the videos, sometimes some videos get lost. I'll link all the playlists down below. Go into my jewelry ones, and in a lot of my videos, I cover little things here and there for or from Van Cleef & Arpels. So that might be really helpful, especially I believe the unboxing and sometimes my most used, or I don't know, different videos that I cover different things. But I'm truly hoping that I covered everything. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. You could always DM me on Instagram. I'm pretty good at replying there as well. So I really hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. I really hope you guys stay healthy and safe, and have a great day or night. I will see you guys on my next video. Bye guys.